Hello everybody, Mr. Rum here. Welcome back to Factorio. In the last episode, we worked on trying to create resin for our eventual fiberglass boards that we're going to need to make for our new circuit boards. And we're doing urea formaldehyde resin, which from what I understand is actually a fairly common resin. And now to do that, we had to do some catalytic conversion of our methanol into formaldehyde, and we are borrowing our existing urea gas production, which should be fine, I hope. I hope we can sustain that. We have the production chain for it. But that should be good to go. And so now we need to find a place to bring our fiberglass where we're going to be manufacturing the glass fibers and the resin to where we're going to be manufacturing our fiberglass boards. And so, I have to decide where that's actually going to happen. Now, this is our electronics production here, right? Current electronics production, and we have batteries over here, so I think it would make sense just to keep going in this direction. Make electronics kind of down this area. Thing is, I would have to pipe that resin all the way over there. And not impossible to do that. But if we're going to do it down here, we might as well just divert off our glass. Glass here and bring it down by belt instead of by train. Because we're going to want to grab onto the existing basic electronic components and the existing transistors and the existing solder. And the existing silicon wafers and all that kind of stuff that's already down here. Right? So, I'm gonna see, is there a way? That I could have a spot we could put maybe even the resin on rails? Because I could put some loading areas over here with the trains, it wouldn't be a problem. We could bring it over here. Yeah, and we could just belt it down. I think we're just gonna have to pipe it and belt it. I think that's just the way that's gonna work. Which is fine. I have the pipes and the belts. So it'll work. Follow this carbon dioxide line. We're going to divert here. This is where things are gonna get. Slightly tricky. Can I get all the way across that? No, I cannot. Okay. Well, what I could do. Put all that underground. Just made it through there. Get it through there. All right. So there's our resin. And then here is where we would be putting. I'm pretty sure it'd be here. Where we would be putting our, fiberglass board. Not listed there. Fiber. It says it should be able to be made in an assembly machine. Have I not researched it? Angel smelting. Fiberglass board. There it is. Weird. Okay. Okay, so that's where it is, and then this is where our This is where our glass is. I have a lot stored. We can always run another belt. That's not a problem. So they want to build this by hand. But we do have a bit of a gap here in the coverage for our logistics system. Close that in. Okay. Okay. So we'd have our belts. Through like that. Actually, no. It would not come through here. It would be coming through there. So that'll get built in here. All right. So, next thing we're going to need to do is we need to take some resin and we need to make some rubber because we need to make the insulated wire. And that uses tinned copper wire. From here. Okay. We have resin here. So we can use an electric furnace. Yeah, we actually will use the electric furnace. Seems like we're actually we have more resin capacity than we are consuming. This is natural resin and natural rubber as opposed to the artificial stuff. It's not going to use a lot. Here. Guess we're gonna do a little bit of borrowing the space. You are gonna make insulated wire, which is here. Is over here. Need to take off some of that. Ah, it will come all the way through. Okay. That's what I wanted to do. And drop it there. Okay, so we only need one of those. All right then. Oh, because it makes an absolute ton per cycle. Alright, fair enough. Oh, that won't work, will it? No, it won't. One more block. And that can head in that direction. Oh, right. Yeah, you need to be... There we go. So we're gonna need silver and copper plates. And here's copper. I can do is I can double up on that. Just to make sure that we're making enough. So there's copper. Go ahead and double it up onto that belt. We need silver plates. Which is right here. I mean, it is right there. That's silver. Okay, so we'll divert that where it's needed. And we're gonna need ferric chloride solution. Which there should be right there. It's got to get kind of jogged around here. Okay. Bring the silver in there. All Actually, something machine 2. You only need 4 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Okay, if we use electronics and sewing machines, we just need less of them. Okay. Ferric chloride solution. We'll need some space to bring that through. All right, and we're also going to need some space. Silver through. Yeah, we'll leave that on one side of the belt. So the next thing we need to make are, we need an electronics assembly machine. We can bring in the insulated wires, some sulfuric acid. All right, so we need to put something else on this belt here. Maybe plastic. Where is our plastic? Plastic is here. There. Plastic, and then we're going to need one that's going to have silicon wafers. So we need to direct the silicon wafer somewhere. To come through here. There we are. Silicon wafers. And sulfuric acid. And sulfuric acid is right there. So that can get routed through to here. We have one electronics assembly machine. And the way we're actually going to set this up. Put those on nuclear electronics, or put that on that belt. Actually, yeah, actually we need to do it like this. Have our integrated electronics. So now that's done, and that's done, and now we just need to grab some basic electronic components, our transistors. We probably need to expand those production a little bit, and solder, and then we can make electronic logic boards. But we will get that done next episode. So we'll stop here for now. So if you guys enjoyed it, thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you next time.